All right, you guys, this is your girl, Nya York. I am coming again with money management, specifically how I got out of $87,000 of debt. Okay, so last week I made a video and I talked about that I was gonna start putting out small videos, maybe once a week, and give you guys some tips of how you can also get out of debt if you have debt. If you don't have debt, you can use these videos to save money, plan for that vacation that you always wanted, buy a house, or just build wealth, build your retirement portfolio. So today is gonna be my second video, and this video I'm gonna talk about my why. So the reason I'm gonna talk about my why is because I want you to discover your why you want to do what I'm asking you to do, or why do you want to get out of debt? Why do you want to pay off your house? Why do you want to anything to do with finances? So the number one thing, the first step, is knowing why you want to do something. Okay, Darren Hardy, he is the author and editor of Success Magazine. This is the independent magazine throughout the US. It's called Success Magazine. Darren Hardy, he said, if your why is strong enough, you can do almost anyhow. Okay, that is a pretty big statement. It's not a matter of how to do things, it's a matter of whether you have a big reason enough why you want to do what you want to do. Because when your why is not strong enough, you will give up. Okay, so I'm going to talk to you guys today about why I wanted to pay off $87,000 and why I did it in 10 months. And hopefully that will allow you to start thinking about your own why. So I'm going to try to make this very short, brief, so that you're not sitting here for 15 minutes listening to me. So again, this whole thing, this whole journey started in 2019. In 2019, I found myself in Wounded Warrior in the Army. Okay, Army Wounded Warrior, getting ready for separation from the military due to PTSD, depression, anxiety, back pain. I was just going through a lot mentally, and it all stems, from personal issues that I was having. So, when I was in when I was in the Wounded Warrior, they gave me 4 to 6 months before I separated. Okay, in September of 2019, I took the Financial Peace University through Dave Ramsey. Highly recommended, but that's not why we're here. We're here for something else. So, I took that class, and by December, I started my separation, my Med Board evaluation. So I knew from December of 2019, I have 4 to 6 months, and that's when I made a plan. The reason I wanted to get off, I wanted to pay off that debt was because, one, I was not in a stable mental status to be getting out of the Army and finding a work to support me and my kids. I just knew that I can't mentally. I was not functional to go home and work. So I want to be able to go home and sit down and take care of my mental health, and not worry about having to support myself and my kids. So I look around my finances, and I knew whatever the Army decided to compensate me for after they relieved me from duty, it would be enough to take care of me and my children if I don't have the debt. Okay? You guys understand. If I didn't have the debt that I have, whatever the Army compensate me would be enough to care for me and my children without having to worry about getting a job. But if I carry that debt with me to retirement, I would have to find a job because it would not sustain me and my kids and still paying those creditor. Okay, I got these debt from three sources. One, I use credit cards to remodel an investment home that I purchased, which it was a bad idea, but at the time I was planning to get money back from the home when I sell it. But the home, as like any investment, there are risks, and it sat in the market for over a year, so I lost everything in that home. So I didn't have the money to pay back these credit cards I had used to remodel the home too. I purchased a car. And if you ever take Dave Ramsey, he does not believe in debt. So going that through that class, I realized my car payment was a debt. So I included that into my money. And the last one was a trip that my family and I took to Kenya in summer of 2019. So we had put $10,000 on a credit card, my credit card. So altogether it was $87,000 of debt. So I needed to pay that. Main thing was because I was not in a stable mental status to work after I get out of the army. So that was my why. Let me tell you guys about the importance of why. The important why, your why will be the driving force that will get you up every day to go to work, to have an extra job, to say no to your friends. You can't go out with them and eat because you don't have enough money. You put your money toward your goal, or it's going to be the reason why you're going to skip out on that vacation. The reason why you'd rather put money away than spending them on those nice shoes, those new Nikes or new Jordan that just came out. If your why is strong enough, you will do anything. For example, let me give you an example. Let's say that your child is standing on top of a building and you are on top of another building, a 30-foot building. And between the buildings is a log, okay? So there's this big long stick from one building to the next. And I said, I want you to walk from this building to the next, to the other building, and I'll give you $40. You probably look at me and say, you crazy? You want me to walk across the log for $40? Hell no, I'm not doing that. But let's say your child is on fire. That building is on fire, and your child is on top of the building, and the log is still there, it's still the same height. And I said, your child is gonna get on fire if you don't walk through that and get your child. You probably would walk through that log to the next building to go get your child, $40 or not. Am I right? Yeah, you would. You would walk whether I pay you $40 or not, because now you're strong. Your why is stronger than $40. Your why is your child. So that's how strong your why has to be. You will do almost anything, okay? So what I need you to do before the next video is find out your why. Find out your why. You want to do what you want to do with money. It could be anything, but it has to be stronger than just the money itself. It's never about the money. It's the reason behind it. So this video is about knowing your why, having a strong why. And next time we'll get into step one. What is the first step I did to get out of my debt, or the second step after I figure out my why? Okay, so I will see you guys on the next video. These video will be posted on my YouTube channel, Nyajoktomi, and also on my Instagram, Nyamagra. Other than that, I wish you luck, and I'll see you on the next video. All right, bye-bye.